women's doubles group A. And as you can see from the matches so far, Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yang, the reigning world champions, won both of their matches, and so too have the Koreans. And they play against each other now. This, of course, will decide who wins Group A in the women's doubles. Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yang, the number one seeds, against Jung Kyung-yang and Kim Ha-na of Korea. And the arena looking absolutely splendid with the three courts for the badminton competition. And of course, when badminton has finished, then this venue will be taken over for the rhythmic gymnastics. A lot of London 2012 has all been about sustainability and recycling. And of course, this particular venue was built in 1934 for the Empire Games, which of course we know better today as the Commonwealth Games. And in fact, it was used during the 1948 Olympic Games for swimming, diving, water polo, and indeed boxing. And the pool, the Empire Pool, Wembley, as this venue used to be called, is still here today, but it's hidden underneath the building here. Used, of course, for many a pop concert. It really is one of the iconic arenas here in London. Sixth time badminton has been in the Olympic Games. And the first time we've had group stages, round robin play in both doubles and singles. In the doubles, the top 16 pairs divided into four groups of four. So three matches within the group for every pair, and the top two will progress through to the quarterfinal stage. Singles a little bit different, because in the men's singles we've had 40 players divided into 16 groups. And in case you think my maths is a bit wrong, I should point out that eight of the groups in the men's singles, only two players. So in essence, within those eight groups, which are the top eight seeds, just a straight knockout to see who would progress through to the knockout stage. And just 16 players in the knockout stage in the singles, so you have to top your group in the singles. Women's singles, there was 46 players in the group stages, so just two groups where only two players contested the group. Today is group stage. Knockout competition will follow. Well, you could hear the announcements, the technical officials coming on to court. And the Group A match, this women's doubles. Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yang up against Jung Kyung-eun and Kim Ha-na from Korea.
Next on court two, it's the women's doubles group A match. Please welcome, representing the People's Republic of China, Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yang.
So here come the world champions, the number one seeds, Wang Xiaoli, leading out Yu Yang. Kyung-eun, of course, is the defending Olympic champion, and he won the gold medal 4 years ago in Beijing with Du Jing. Korean opponents Jung Kyung-eun and Kim Hana. Greeted by the match officials. Tsutomu Toi of Japan will be the umpire. Mark Spates from Germany, the service judge. So the Koreans won the toss. And they have chosen to serve. Three choices available in badminton if you win the toss. You can choose to serve, you can choose to receive, or you can choose which end you wish to start. So the Koreans have decided they wish to serve. Chinese pair have chosen which end they will start. So this match, a straight playoff to determine who will top the group. Young and Wang Xiaoli up against Kim Hana and Jung Kyung-eun. Both the Korean players, 22 years of age, and this young lady from Jeju, the southern island of the south of South Korea. And there's her partner from Gangnam. Number 8 in the world rankings, this Korean pair. Of course, in the badminton doubles, only 4 seeds. Wang Xiaoli from Hubei province in China, 23 years of age. And her partner, Yu Yang, 26, from Haicheng in Liaoning province. 26-year-old, not only that gold medal 4 years ago in the women's doubles, also picked up a bronze in the mixed doubles with He Hanbin. And I should think the Chinese pair will be very happy to be back here in Wembley, because of course this is where they won their world title together. Thanks. Tian Qing and Zhao Yunlei in that final, world championship final. In 2011.
Ladies and gentlemen, open light, Jokyeon, Kim Hana, Korea. On the left, Wang Xiaoli, Yuyang, China.
So the Korean pair of Jung Kyung-eun and Kim Hana, nearest to us, getting this Group A decider underway against the number one seeds, the reigning world champions, Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yang. This is just the second time that these two pairs have met each other. The previous time was in the quarterfinal of the China Masters, and it was a very convincing win for the current world champions. 21-10, 21-17. When you look at China's pairs' remarkable record since they formed their partnership, which was formed straight after they played against each other in the final of the World Championships in Paris. They really have had a remarkable time. 15 titles, including 13 Super Series in the last year, and all 5 Premier Super Series.
really does show you, Jill, the incredible amount of depth in Chinese badminton. To be able to pick and choose between a world champion and a silver medalist and split them up and mix their pairs up.
Service fault called, struck above the waist, says our service judge, Mark Spate. Yes, it really is astonishing because, I mean, those world championships in Paris, not only did all the women's doubles pairs get swapped around, and I have to say, I think it was an inspirational decision because they've now got three or four pairs that really are dominating world badminton, whereas I think they only had two pairs previously, with the retirement of so many players after the Olympic Games in Beijing. Well, I have to say, things look a little bit sloppy at the moment for the world champions. Service being called, and that's an end struck above the waist.
A very slow start, very lethargic start from both pairs.
Well, they've only played three tournaments so far this year, one Xiaoli and Yu Yang, three individual tournaments that is. One Indonesian Super Series event, that's a premier event. Beaten in the All-England final and lost in the semi-final of the Korean Super Series event, and that was the first time that they had ever been beaten prior to the final when they hadn't had to withdraw injured. I remember they lost officially first round in China when Wang Xiaoli was carried off court with an injury. Well, this, quite frankly, is not what we had hoped for. Just, well, Kim Moon-soo, the coach there, was he with Park Jubong in the first ever Olympic champions in men's doubles in badminton in Barcelona in 1992. And if I heard correctly, I think he said to the umpire that the Chinese, he felt the Chinese weren't trying. Well, well, the crowd here are getting a little impatient with this. All I can do is tell you that the winner of this match would be placed in the knockout draw. Oh, hang on, wait a minute. The umpire's going to have a word with all four players. Yep. Well, he's switched off his microphone, which means that we can't hear him. And he has told the players, if my lip reading is correct, I must play. I think the umpire has realised that perhaps the desire to win this encounter because of what has happened in other matches in the groups, and therefore knowing who's got through and who will be which end of the draw. Well, quite frankly, this is descending into farce. Well, I really think that the tournament referee needs to step in here. This is an absolute disgrace. Tournament referee has been called for, and here comes Torsten Berg. Let's see if we can hear what he's saying. Well, the referee is calling the players together. Well, it was quite clear what tournament referee Torsten Berg has told them, that if they don't compete to win, both pairs can be disqualified and they would be out of the competition. I've never seen anything like this before. There is the Korean coach, Kyung-eun. He's absolutely livid. Well, I suggest that the players need to be extremely careful here, because I know Torsten Berg, and I know that he's a man of his word. And if these two pairs were disqualified, this would be an absolute tragedy. This game points to the Koreans. Well, a very sarcastic clap from the Korean coach, Kyung-eun. Here comes the tournament referee again. Both teams have been disqualified. This is absolutely extraordinary. He has given both teams a black card, or has he threatened them with a black card? I'm really not terribly sure. The players have returned to court. Well, this, I'm very sorry to say, could be one of the biggest news stories of the games so far. I hope to goodness that all four players on court realise the gravity of the situation. I hope they realise what they're doing to the reputation of what is a wonderful sport. And I hope to goodness that here in the second game they actually start competing with the integrity and the oath that was taken on behalf of every athlete at the opening ceremony. At least we're seeing some rallies now, because in the opening game, serves into the net, serves out wide. An opening game lasting 9 minutes. The two top 10 pairs in the world. Well, it's quite obvious what the crowd think of this. Any words from me are at this moment. I can tell you is that these two players have the ability that we've seen already here in the Olympic competition to play a little better than this. So it is the Koreans who won the opening game, who have a substantial lead here in the second.
Seven, four,
park wall for 20 seconds of the timeout remaining. Of the crowd is speaking more than I could possibly put into words. A rally. Longest rally of the opening game was 4 strokes. That beat it by some considerable margin. See the tournament referee, Torsten Berg, in the background. Show their displeasure. Quick serve is long, and up come match points. Thank you.